Hi, everyone. Welcome to the latest addition to the Stephen M. Ross Athletic Campus. $168 million. Construction crews broke ground in the summer of 2015 and are now just finishing up with last-minute details. You know, Michigan has over 900 student-athletes, and more than half of them will train right here at this world-class facility. Members of the men's and women's track and field teams looked on in amazement.
Oh, baby.
One by one, getting their first look at their new home. And what a home it is. This place is sensory overload, featuring state-of-the-art everything, including a banked hydraulic track and indoor-outdoor bays for weight throwers.
It's honestly breathtaking. I've seen it, a bunch of pictures, but they really don't do it justice. It's honestly just, being a fifth-year senior, that's a pretty awesome privilege to get this for my last year here.
There is no thoughts. It's just that amazing. Just seeing everything around is brand new, bright colors. It's just great. I don't have any words. It's really nice.
The fact that they care enough to give us the best indoor facility in the world is an extreme honor, and I'm so thankful to be at a university that cares about each of their athletes.
For the first time in the 22-year history of the women's varsity rowing team, the Wolverines have a permanent home.
It's just incredible to see, from the ergo room to the water tanks to the gym facilities to the snack facilities. Just everything's absolutely incredible.
There's even a rowing tank that will take training to a whole new level.
It's just like everything I thought it would be and more. It's unbelievable, and I can't believe that we get to use it.
The lacrosse teams have had a long journey to arrive at this point. For that portion of the story, here's Anthony Polidano.
Thanks, Ed. With five separate venues for games, locker rooms, and coaching offices, the lacrosse programs have been the athletic department's nomads for the past few seasons. Well, they've found a home now.
The programs have already been practicing on the field visible from State Street for a couple of months. But this was their first look inside the facility that they'll call home. Everything the lacrosse players need is now under one roof, with a brand new field just a tunnel away, right next door. For the veterans on the teams like PJ Boggle and Bianca Bruckner, their programs have come a long way from their humble beginnings since being announced as a varsity program back in 2011.
Just amazing. It's even better than I was expecting, and my team is so excited to be able to use this facility and be able to play this season here, so we're really excited.
Everything is all in one location, so it's easy to have that one-stop shop. We just kind of come down, you can kind of take care of business here. You hit the indoor turf, you can take care of schoolwork, you can hit the weight room. It just provides you with all the resources you need to continue to excel.
Teams will be practicing here throughout the month of December, but the official move-in date is January 2nd, when the entire facility will be open to them. For MGoBlue.com, I'm Ed Kingerski.